728 its cube root. So again, make the prime factors of 1728. It's a even number, so divide it by even prime number 2. 2 8s are 16, 2 6s are 12, and 2 4s are 8. Again divided by 2. 2 4s are 8, 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4. As we got even number, so we divided by even prime number 2. 2 2s are 4. 2 1s are 2, 2 6s are 12. 2 1s are 2, 0s are 0, and 2 8s are 16. 2 5s are 4, 10. 2 4s are 8. Again we divide it by 2. 2 2s are 4, 2 7s are 14. Now 27 is an odd number, so divide it by a odd prime number. It's a 3. 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 9, and 3 1s are 3. So write the prime factors of 1728 are, 2 is repeated 6 times, so write here a 2 6 times, and 3 is repeated 3 times. As in the question they have said to find the cube root, so take a cube root on the both sides. Cube root of 1728 and cube root of 2 is written again 6 times and 3 is written 3 times. As they are saying to find the cube root, so we have to make the grouping of the 3 same numbers. So we have to find the root of cube. So cube, make that 3 pairing numbers pairing. Alright, as 2 index 3, 2 index 3, and the 3 index 3, and its cube root. As the indices of the numbers are same, so write it just one time. And 2 multiply 2 multiply by 3. Cube is cancelled with a cube root, and the remaining numbers we got 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 and multiply them. 2 2s are 4 and 4 3s are 12. So the cube root of 1728 is 12. Next, move toward the question number 4. In the question number 4, they are saying the prime factorization is given. So the given prime factorization of 9801 is 3 power 4 multiply 11 square, and we have to find its a square root. As they have already given the prime factorization, so just write here the prime factor of 9801 are 3 power 4 multiply 11 square. And they said find a square root, so take a square root on both sides. So square root of 9801 and a square root of 3 index 4 and multiply 11 square. As they said find a square root, so split 3 index 4 as a 3 square and a 3 square. We just split here 3 index 4 into 3 square and a 3 square, and the index now the same, so combine them and cancel the square root with the square. So remaining numbers are 3 multiply 3 multiply 11. As a square root of 9801,
9801 is a positive, so right here only positive square root of a number 99. So 99 is a square root of 9801. The question number 5 is prime factorization of 21952 is given as 2 index 6 and a 7 multiply 7 cube. So we have to find the cube root. Again, following the steps of the previous question, write here the prime factorization of 21952. These are 2 power 6 or multiply 7 cube. As they are saying to find a cube root, so take a cube root on the both sides. Apply a cube root. As we have to find a cube root, for this purpose we will split the 2 index 6 into the index 3. So split them, 2 index 6 into 2 index 3 and the 2 index 3 again. Multiply with the 7 index 3 and it's a cube root. Now the indices are same, so combine them. 2 multiply by 7 and a cube cancel with the cube root and the remaining numbers are 2 multiply by 7. Multiply them to 2's are 4 and multiply by 7 it gives the 28. So the cube root of 21952 is 28. Next, move toward the next question, an important one, the story sum question number 8. Question number 8 is a story sum. It's a very important question. We just change here the value from the book. It's a 200,000 and a 500. So in the question they have saying the area of square photo frame. They have clearly indicate the frame in the shape of square. So we will write here statement area of photo frame which is in the shape of square is 2500 centimeters square. And they said find its perimeter. Perimeter of photo frame we have to find out. As we know the square have all the four sides are equal in a length, and we also learned in the previous classes the formula of area of the square and also the perimeter of square. As the area of square is a side multiplied by side or the length multiplied by length, we can also write it as a now index notation form L square. And in the question they said find the perimeter of a square. It's a 4 multiplied by L. For this purpose, length of the one side we have to find out. The length of the side is not given in the question. So firstly we will find out. As in the question, area of the frame is given. So use this information which is given in the question. So write here the area of photo frame. And the area of the frame which is the shape of square is right here L square. So right L square is value of the area is given 2500. As we know the square will cancel out with the square root. So apply the square root on both sides. L square and 2500 and its square root. And in the previous question number 3, we solved the square root by the prime factorization. So apply there again the method. So make the prime factors of 2500 as we makes in the previous questions. So 2 2's are 4, 2 5's are 10 and 0 again we divided by 2, 2 6 are 12, 2 2's are 4, 2 5's are 10, 6 and 25 is divided by 5, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 fives are 25, again with 5, 5 twos are 10 and 5 fives are 25, and 5 fives are 25 and 5 ones are 5. So write all these prime factors under a square root sign. 2 is repeated 2 times and a 5 is repeated 4 times, so write them. And then we have to find the by the square root. So make the pairing of the two same numbers and write in the index of the two. Combine the index. Square cancel out with a square root and the remaining 2 multiply 5 multiply 5. And here again square is cancel out with a square root, so remaining is length only. Length of photo frame is, multiply them, 2 5s are 10 and 10 5s are 50, so it's a 50 centimeter. And still the question is remaining. We have to find its a perimeter. The perimeter of photo frame, we can calculate it by the formula of the perimeter of square. It's a 4L. Substitute the value of L. We calculate it. It's a 50. So multiply them. It gives the 4 multiply by 5 to 20. So 200 is the perimeter of photo frame. Next, move toward the question number 9. Again, it's a very important question.
Question number 9 is, the volume of the box in the shape of cube is given. So firstly, write the information whatever is given. Volume of box, which is the shape is cube, is given 2197 centimeter cube. Before solving the question, we have to understand what is the cube. A cube is a six-sided closed figure like this box, as it has a six side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and at bottom side it's a six side, and all the six sides in the shape of the square, when combine the six squares, it gives a perfect cube. As the box has the six sides and all the sides of in the shape of square, so formula of the volume of the cube box we have learned also. It's a volume of box which in the shape of cube is L cube. As we learned, all the lengths are equal in the sides. So, length, breadth and the height are also have the same measurements. So, the formula of the cube is, volume of the cube is L cube. But in the question they said, find the area of one side of the box. For finding the area, we have also find the length of the one side. So, firstly, right here L cube, which is a given is 2197. And cube will cancel out with the cube root. So take a cube root on the both sides. Cube root of L cube and a cube root of 2197. Again, make the prime factors of 2197. It's a clearly odd number, so only the odd prime numbers can divide the numbers. By following all the applying all divisibility test, we just recognize that we just draw a conclusion that 13 is the only number which can divide the 2197. So divided by 13, 1s are 13 and remaining is 13, 6 is 78, and then 13, 9 is 117. And 169 again divided by 13, it's a perfect square of the 13. So 13, 1s are 13 and 13, 3s are 39. 13 is a prime number, so divided by itself. So the cube is cancelled out with the cube root. And right here the length L is cube of root of 13 multiply 13 multiply by 13. As we have to find the cube root, so 13 is repeated 3 times. So right here as an index 3, cube cancelled with the cube root. So the length of side of box is 13 centimeter. And still the question is here, area of one side of the box. As the box is in the shape of cube and all the six sides are in the shape of square, when the six squares joins makes a perfect cube, so we have to find the area of any one side. So let's suppose we are going to find the area of the top side in the shape of the square. So write here the formula, area of square, which is area of one side of box which in the shape of square, it's a L square. So take a 13 square, it's a 169. So when 13 multiply by itself, it gives a 169. So 169 centimeter square is the area of one side of a box. I hope you will understand exercise 1A. Now in here the exercise 1A is completed. Now next move toward the exercise 1B. Problems and the questions of the 1B is discussed in the next video.